Come out of the box. Out the box.
Hello, YouTube. Cheers, and welcome to the basement. My name is Bruce Lively.
Once again, I'm D-Boy Slim.
And The Basement is the first daily hip-hop debate show. From Tuesday through Friday, we tackle the most intriguing topics in hip-hop culture and the world around it. So welcome back, Basement family. It's Wednesday, and that can only mean one thing. It's City Wrecking Wednesdays, where we take two cities steeped in hip-hop culture and music and put them head-to-head in an epic debate on influence, quality of artists, producers, even slang and fashion if we have to. Anything we think makes one city get that Wednesday hip hop crown. As always, City Wrecking Wednesdays is brought to you by Fleetwood Spice Collection. For a spice-changing experience, give the Fleetwood Spice Collection a try. Big, bold, flavors unlike anything you've tried before. The Fleetwood Spice Collection, people, it's time to change your spice. Today's question: Houston versus Philly.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. With that being said, let go.
We back.
Yes, we are.
What's going on out there, YouTube?
Back indeed. Full effect.
Today we coming at y'all with two largely respected and historical cities.
City Wrecking Wednesdays.
For music and beyond. But we're going to stick to hip-hop. And we're going to do our best to represent Houston versus Philly today.
Who you got today?
It's Philly, y'all. Y'all know what it is. It's Philly.
Let's do it.
I ain't gonna do y'all wrong too. I'm gonna represent it right too. You know, Philly is a large history as far as hip hop. Some could easily argue it's been there since the beginning of hip hop. As a matter of fact, I'm not gonna start in the back. And we all know that Will Smith, you know, Fresh Prince, and DJ Jazzy Jeff.
Ooh.
That's where they're from.
Ooh.
It's to touch on how far they go back. We talking 88, 89. Summertime, their most famous single, I think, came out in 91.
Here it is, a groove slightly transformed. Just a bit of a break from the norm. Just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit.
They won the Grammy for it. They was platinum before that. With singles like Parents Just Don't Understand, Girls of the World Ain't Nothing But Trouble. I like to get into the era that I came up in, which is always referred to as the golden era, the 90s rap. This is when I was put on the groups like The Roots.
The anticipation arose as time froze. I stared off the stage with my eyes closed and dove into the deep cosmos. The impact pushed back the first five rows. But before the raw live shows, I remember eyes a little snot nose, rocking gazelle, God goes and eyes eye closed. Learning the ropes of ghetto survival. People not the situation, I had to slide through.
So y'all, if you followed hip hop over the last 25 years, then you can't say that you know hip hop without saying you know the roots. Without saying you don't know the roots.
So you mean the Tonight Show Band?
Now some of y'all may know him from Late Night with Jimmy Fallon, which that's what stands out number one about them.
The Tonight Show.
And it's that, you know, it's the fact that they're a band, first and foremost, which is unique in itself. True. You don't see that a lot. They're true musicians.
True.
Questlove is a true drummer.
True.
I can't remember the guy's name. Keep the chew stick in his mouth. He plays the guitar, though, you know. Can't remember his name. You got Malik B and of course Black Thought.
Knowing I'm sowing seeds, let's see who summons the greenest. If I said it, I mean it, and did it because I need it. Eat, sleep it, and bleed it. Write it down and then read it. Ask for to the semen. Your trash talk is deleted. Blast off, I lay your mouth like a Tempur-Pedic. Black Thought, I told you I'ma win eventually. This unsung, underrated, underappreciated. The one, them underachievers had underestimated. Finally,
they had an independent album come out first in 93, if I'm not mistaken. In 93, 94. And 95 is when they came out with the album We Want More. And this is when I caught on and half the world caught on to the Roots. They had the song, they had the single As We Proceed to Continue to Rock the Mic, I Shall Proceed and Continue to Rock the Mic. Moving on, in 96 they had the Illadelph Halftime. Those had joints on it like Hypnotic.
Split and listen to the debarge. Let the shorty hit me with a massage to anoint, lubricating my meridian points. That was the summer, easy to remember. Alana was all up on Tariq agenda. How I used to backbender. She even told her best friend, Blender from Virginia, who asked me.
Outstanding music, 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 music.
Which
is the bar that they set, and you know, was kind of Philadelphia's hallmark, you know, calling card, was that, you know, you're gonna hear quality music coming out of Philly. The street thing, they do that too. You know, some of the best dudes coming out there spitting them raps about the streets in detail. Major Figures, legendary group out of Philadelphia. Why? Because all of them can hold their own.
Yeah, Playboy, we gon' get that dough. Face of the Cartier, tic-tac-toe. Cast saying spade, where you get that flow? To the sky when I hit that.
Lava, mommy wanna now and put the down. Nah, love, she love me when I'm smooth, but she hate me when I'm dumb. She love me in them jewels, player never been a scrub.
Yeah, that's sus. Ballin' in them cars, in them cheeks, and that's sus. You ain't seen your broad in a week. A young blue chip, too slick. Move, too spit, too out the news. You won't do a lot of women, but I really like a few chicks. Firing things like you tip, player, I do this.
Go check out the sermon by Ab Lava. I know my partner is ready to get on and tell about Houston, and he's gonna tell me that we gotta wrap this up because we don't have a lot of time. But truth is, Philly has a lot of MCs, a lot of historic quality classic music coming out that city.
I mean, I'm gonna be honest with you, man. Sound good. You sound good.
Facts.
Believe it or not, except for the Roots, this is the same sound in hip hop. Houston, as far as the hip-hop culture is concerned, we're looking at a plethora of unique and different voices. Each one's different from the other one and different from everything else that might have been going on at the time. Number two, we're going to be looking at the influence, not only in production and music, but in the style, in the slabs that they ride in, and the slang that they use. What we have in Houston is a hip-hop culture that wasn't borrowed and isn't filtered. It's brand new and has changed the game, and it still continues to. Number three, looking at history and icons. Yeah, we know Philly has history and icons. Well, Houston does too, as well as these other things. Number one, let's get to the unique voices. Look at Chamillionaire.
Somebody tell him it's murder.
Murder was the case, and they blame me.
Officer, I didn't do it. You can't blame me for this. Could you please loosen up the handcuffs on my wrist?
What else is like that? When you see the dude in the white face on the news talking about the police with the crazy beat, Hip Hop Police is over 11 million views. But right next to him is someone from the same city, Travis Scott. Listen to this guy.
Popping pills is all we know. In the hills is all we know. Don't go through the front door. In the show. Everything I ever had in the show. Ooh, had the night show.
Completely different. EDM, young style, alternative, different, completely different. Also with the millions of views. And then right next to them, you see, you might look at yourself as a hip-hop historian. I know you don't know who Lecrae is. Right next to all of this, right next to the SZA, you got the gospel rapper, who's one of the most well-known rappers. Most people don't know that he's a gospel rapper because he's just that good. He features on everybody's stuff. Lecrae? Yeah. That's another couple million, 67 million.
I know one thing's true. Yeah. I don't even really deserve to know you, but I'm a witness that you did this, and I'm brand new, so I'm ready to go, and I'ma tell the world what they need to know. A slave to myself, but you let me go. I tried getting high, but it left me low. Jesus being alive, every day I live, I'm trying to show the world why. Christ is more than everything I'll ever try. Better than pretty women, sitting and living, and get a minute of any women, a minute you and mine. It ain't no lie, we creep.
If we're on the first subject, people, this is the unique voices. You see, there's something important about a city that comes out with this many unique voices, voices that sound like nothing else, that push the culture forward. And when you're talking about pushing the culture forward in a voice that's unique, musically and vocally, Trey the Truth.
I keep a heater, everything on me covered in ice. I'm on this white sand, maybe somewhere lost in Cuba. And I keep a shooter there to disappear you like Bermuda. So many chains hanging off Young Truth, I should have been a jeweler. This bitch I got ain't dropping out the truth for sure, gon' school her. Cooler. Ain't shit that's real as me. The same book, but I still ain't been to see. Get money, way too much to count. I should work, don't shit get sent to me.
Go listen to Trey the Truth. And then we have all the way back to UGK, Bun B, Pimp C. If you thought you was talking about pimping, you was not. Not like them. Distinct voice, distinct sound. Now, the second point I was saying was influence in the culture of hip-hop. The slangs, who you know riding candy paint? Slabs. Gangsta Grizzles. What's the best-selling grills out there right now? This is Paul Wall. Okay? It might seem like, well, what is he talking about? I'm talking about the culture of hip-hop. If you don't know Paul Wall and his grills, you're probably missing out on the culture. If you don't know what the slabs are, you're probably missing out on the culture. Look at their whole entire car culture. Go see the car shows down there. It's all hip-hop. And I'm talking about DJ Screw, who turned music on his head with the slowdown. Talking about SZA, people. You, these things may be good or bad. I feel you. But this is in the hip-hop culture, and this has started in Houston. They have a monopoly on this, on these things. And spread it out. And spread it out. Whether you like it or not, you have to take that fact into consideration. And my third point, we're talking about the history and the icons. The reason why we say UGK is from Houston is because they shout out Houston many times, as well as PA, Port Arthur. The reason why we say the history and the icons in Houston are far-reaching is because of a man named Scarface, people. Not only the Ghetto Boys, which was an iconic group, but Scarface himself, which became an icon in hip-hop.
Drake or the blue dots of your block, you probably bred a fat pad of Tupac, a big pun of B.I., your homeboys from knee high, and even when it was storming outside, that shit be by, that's me, dog, on my block, I ain't had to play the big shot, knew me back when I was stealing beer from Shamrock, and my nickname was Creepy, if Black Joe could see me, he'd be tripping, and I bet he still try to tease me.
You went out to get the shit that mommy never bought me. Only 10 years old and I can't stay away from trouble. But you don't give a fuck cause you ain't never had the struggle. And everybody's telling me it's getting greater later. I need to get my shit right now cause it ain't shit in my refrigerator.
DJ Screw. I mean, these are icons. So, like I said, to recap, unique voices. The unique voices in the city that permeate throughout hip-hop and had nothing else like them. Number two, the influence in the culture. We're talking about Gangsta Grills, talking about DJ Screw, the style of music. Listen to UGK, those style of beats no one was doing before. And the history and the icons, which are shared with Philly in all reality. They have a lot of history, a lot of icons. But everything else, I got it. Houston.
Once again.
There goes the sigh.
This guy is way off. You know.
It hurts. I know.
All I really heard from this guy's soliloquy is that they talk differently. He said the voices are unique.
No, unique voices.
And they talk differently.
Not in music.
Your voice would be, would project your speaking.
Okay, no. But also, when you read a book, they say the voice that the book was in. So you have to look at the voice metaphorically, not the actual voice that was coming out the lungs. The unique voices. The voice that they're giving to a certain community, to the car community, to
you want
to
talk
the
voices
gospel.
While this guy's mumbling on like the mumble rappers. You want to talk?
You
want to talk voices?
An intelligent conversation.
You
want
to talk voices? Let's talk freeway. I've never heard a hip hop voice quite like that.
We still hustle till the sun come up. Crack a 40 when the sun go down. It's a cold winter. Y'all better bundle up, and I better be a hotter summer rapper.
That's a voice.
That's a unique voice.
You want to talk voices. Now, again, let's talk about the quality in raps. I heard a lot of yin yang from Yo Way, but I didn't hear about the quality in rap music. Freeway. Let's go into the Philadelphia Freeway. How about Rock the Mic? Over 5 million views. You remember one of your favorite joints with Beanie Sigel. How about Flipside? Yeah, the one with Petey Crack. That's another joint on Freeway.
How about Trader Truth? Hallelujah. How about Trader Truth and T.I.? Check this, dig that. How about Bun B? Anything. Those aren't quality?
Bun is from Port Arthur, Texas, right?
Bun is from Port Arthur, Texas, right?
That's right.
I just said, he. In my third point, that he represented Houston as well.
Is he from Port Arthur?
Okay, well, if that's fine. That's fine.
Yeah, he gets
DJ
excited.
Premier is from Houston.
See how he gets excited.
No, DJ Premier is from Houston.
That does nothing for my argument. I'm talking about Philadelphia.
I'm talking about DJ Premier is from Houston. I could have said that if you're talking about where people. I'm saying what they represent.
You wanted to say that?
What they represent.
If you wanted to say that, say that.
Well, I just had to break your point now.
That's cool.
Which I just
you
did.
Broke my point by saying that Premier's from Houston.
Yep.
And that broke my point.
Just like how UGK's from PA, not Houston.
But in any event, like I said, so you holler UGK all you like. But again, joints like Beanie Sigel, The Truth, which debuted number 4 on the Billboard 200. What My Life Like? What You Really Know What A Thug About? These are joints crazy. Beanie Sigel, to this day, he has joints with Dave East. The Real is back. To this day, Beanie Sigel is still one of the nicest rappers ever to probably touch the mic. Authenticity is nothing that you ever had to worry about when it comes to these rappers out of Philly. We all know that they live what they rapping about. They live what they're talking about.
Trader Truth, Bun B, Lecrae, the gospel rapper, he don't live what he's rapping about.
Who? What?
Lecrae.
What song?
67 million views.
What song?
Tell the World.
Never heard of it.
I know you haven't.
I know you haven't.
Never heard of it.
I know you haven't.
So, yeah, E was another one. Female vocalist, female lyricist, still regarded as one of the best. Eve, can't forget, also repping that 215 in Philly. We can't forget, I didn't forget about Meek Mill and the dudes, and the Cassidys of Philadelphia. And he's known for the battle raps too. This is what Philly does, man. They're lyricists, they're penmen, they're good at what they do. Like I said, if you can argue that they've been here since the beginning of time, since the beginning of hip-hop, and to this day, it's easy to see. In every era, if you look back, Philly's been involved heavily.
We can go on and on, but my main points were not to name every single person in Houston, but to show you the unique voices they have, number 2, the influences they have on the culture, and number 3, the historical icons. I think I've said that enough. I don't need to go anymore. But I hear you, though.
Again, my point was you could name all the dudes in Houston. Quality was my thing when I mentioned the Roots, when I mentioned the Beanie Sigel. Quality. That's the difference.
Okay.
Y'all let us know.
Y'all let us know. It's up to you. Leave them right down there in the comment section.
Who's better represented hip-hop throughout the years? Philly or Houston? H-Town.
There it is.
Both to be respected.
Both to be respected.
Any shout-outs, Bruce?
We got shout-outs today. Wadi Umi. I can't even read your whole thing right now. We went too far. But Wadi Umi, you came back, and we love you for it, man. Basically, he said Big Boy would smash Bun B anytime, any day. And he thinks it's funny to even have the comparison. I agree. Big Boy is 10 times better.
Mr. Fleetwood says Bun B is one of my favorite rappers, bar none. His verse next up was an all-time great verse. It put artists from East Coast or coast to coast on notice about his skills. That being said, Big is far more diverse and just as nice. Two guys with two different lanes. I'd give the edge to Big Boy. This is one based on all categories involved. For my money, Scarface is the best in the South all time, but I'm an old head, so I might be biased.
Hey, it's all good.
We appreciate the comments. Appreciate that, Mr. Fleetwood.
Appreciate that. Listen, thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode today. Don't forget to subscribe. Share this with your friends, man. Share this on Facebook. Share this wherever you can on your social media sites. We provide you with real hip-hop debate. And if you love it, press that subscribe. Share it. Press the like button.
Keep on clicking. We got some dope shows coming up. Y'all don't want to miss it. Or, you know, the Jay-Z album is coming. We're going to talk about that. What's going on with the new rappers versus the old rappers? We're going to talk about that.
Mm.
The Pac movie being done. We're going to talk about some of the best hip-hop movies.
Mm.
We got a lot of dope shows coming up. Y'all be sure to check in.
Don't forget them old ones that we've been there too. You'll like them.
Till the next time, we out of here.
Peace. You wouldn't let it go under 30 minutes, man. You wouldn't let it go. See? You don't realize I gotta get this up before 12 midnight, man.
You good to go, man.
It don't matter. It's the time that it takes.
You just gotta put your little clips in.
I guess the
Or some slabs. Some Houston slabs.
I can't put half the clips in. I wanted to now.